Hello everyone, I'm Mrs. Midnight, and I hope you're ready for the second part of our adventure with Little Misfortune, now in English. So now we reached the point where we left. For the ones that missed the first part, we left the nude club from the hamsters and appeared outside a sewer because apparently Mr. Boyce took us there. So let's go on. And as we see, she is the same girl from the poster, but she vanished. Which means she's not around this world anymore.
Ugh, smells like bullcrap.
Misfortune, watch your language.
Okay.
And it was not even that terrible what she said.
Uni's like the get out.
Very clever, Miss Fortune.
Thank you.
Maybe we could find time to check it out later. Who knows?
Right. Don't play with now.
Let's focus on finding the eternal happiness first. Then we'll see.
All right. I can't wait.
So cute that she really is dying to go to the horror fair.
It's Benjamin from the hoods in the woods. You know, if you ever want to hang out or something, I'm available.
Don't engage with that wild fox. I told you, foxes are dangerous.
Let me handle this. Benji, are you a wild, dangerous fox? No, Benji, don't go!
Let that wild beast run off. I don't want anything bad happening to you.
All right.
Yeah, but it's not really the poor fox you should be worried about.
Ah, this is Benji's stuff. This is absolutely the best art I have ever seen. It's so personal. I didn't know Benjamin was so creative.
Creative? That looks like a child has drawn it.
What did you just say?
Oh, I didn't mean it like that.
Huh.
Hey, shouldn't we be focusing on finding the prize?
I'm focused.
And besides, what did he expect, like impressionism art in a warning sign?
Are we going to the park?
Yes.
Okay.
Apparently we are. And I don't know if the webcam's showing it, but I have happiness in my lips!
Language.
I really don't get what his problem with bad words is. And I know I probably said this previously in the first part, but it really conflicts me. I mean, he's kidnapping the girl. And seriously, he has a problem with bad words?
Mr. Voice?
Yes, Miss Fortune?
Has anyone reached the end of the game and gotten the eternal happiness?
Yes, of course. They lived happily ever after.
That sounds nice. You know, I want to win this prize for my mommy. I wish I could give her some happiness. My sparkle doesn't work with her.
Oh, that's really sweet of you.
Thank you. Would you like to try my sparkle?
That's not necessary.
Don't be silly. Here you go. Happiness to me,
Stan. Yeah, I could never refuse her sparkle.
Oh, well, thank you. Anyway, let's go find the prize and make Mommy proud.
Yes.
Yeah, because eternal happiness has to be in a very happy place. Like a pet cemetery, of course. But then again, part of what Mr. Boyce does is to make reality not make sense. So let's wait for the autosave. Which is really cool, because if you forget to save, you have also the autosave backup.
It says, don't feed the bird. Okay.
Well, it's not like we have much to feed them with.
There's a lot of sweet poetry written on the bench. Death is alive and it's eating from you. Sign and interesting. What do
sounds
you think?
Like a clue.
Misfortune, do you really need to read those poems?
And well, it does bother Mr. Boyce, right? So yeah.
Yeah, listen to this one. Both hanging too low. No signature. Where are they hanging from? Oh look, a drawing of a cat.
Come on, Misfortune, let's go.
Alright.
Alright. Nothing of interest. Except for a drunken seagull.
It looks like Kevin's dad.
Who's that?
He used to sit in the sandbox next to school. He didn't have any clothes on, and the police officer beat him with a stick.
Fascinating. Remember that fish you picked up earlier?
You mean Rodrigo? My fish friend forever?
You should give it to the seagull. I'm sure it would appreciate some company.
I guess that maybe that will be a fair thing to maybe do, I guess.
And nope, of course not, because he's not gonna accompany him, he's gonna eat
if
him.
If you want a fish friend forever, you need to find your own. Rodrigo is my responsibility.
That's very mature of you, Misfortune.
Actually, yeah, with the little information
would
this girl
like
has about life, she's very mature.
Of the park.
Yeah, let's let her ride everything she can.
Royal horse, you say? I'm a little princess, you know.
Because clearly this
Look
girl
at me.
Doesn't get out
I'm
much.
On the horse. Aye, horsey, stop it. Oy. Oh. That was unfortunate.
Are you all right?
I'm okay. Are you worried because I'm such a little lady?
Of course. You are really tiny and you could break.
I broke my arm once.
So you know what I mean.
I've never broken anything, only a fissure. But ouch, sounds painful.
Check out that duck.
Let's just go, Misfortune. You don't want to get involved with ducks.
Don't be silly. Ducks are pretty cool. And look, he's carrying a boombox. This could be my opportunity to finally dance for real.
Would you like to show me some of your dance moves?
And yeah, we should show off a little of our dance moves. Because otherwise the duck breaks the break dances and hits
Check
us.
This out. Okay.
That was unfortunate.
What are you talking about? That was normal.
Oh, if you say
Seriously, you like to smoke? Fine, but why to your daughter's face? I mean, yeah, the dog smoked to her face too, but he's not her father.
Would you like to ride this one? It's like a tornado.
And yeah, sure. She doesn't seem to get out much to play.
Yes, I want to ride. Mika, stop! I can't hold it anymore!
Oh no, Misfortune!
The bastard laughs.
When the trees are naked, when the wind is cold, when the smell of rotten apples smashes against the stone. Apple pie.
Ew, but not a protein.
What are you talking about, Misfortune?
Nothing.
I mean, sure, I like apple pie, but of good apples.
This looks like the art of Benjamin, don't you think?
I think it's garbage, and it should be erased with fire.
Really? I see great potential here. He's obviously very artistic.
Just ignore it. Let's keep playing my game. The prize is closer than you think.
Really? All right.
Yeah, it looks more like it's not convenient for her
feel
for him to for
happiness.
Her to see.
Good. The last challenge awaits at the pet cemetery.
A pet cemetery? That sounds like the best place to end the game.
Exactly my thoughts. I'm glad you feel the same way.
Yeah, sure. Super happy place.
So, I was thinking while we're walking, mind if I ask you a couple of questions?
Sure. I'm pretty good at answering questions.
Great. Just answer as honestly as you can.
All right.
First question. Have you ever stolen anything?
And yeah, Misfortune has.
I stole my friend's Swiss Army knife once. I felt so bad, I buried it in the yard and never told him.
Oh, I'm so sorry for the both of you. Second question. Are you happy right now?
No, I don't think she is, given the life she has.
Well, not really. Many things make me sad. That's why I want the prize so much. Then I can stop pretending I'm always happy.
Ah, I see. Well then, the last question. Do you feel loved?
No, I definitely don't think she does.
No, but my unicorn is telling me that I should work on it. I bet everyone would love me if I was a unicorn.
Thank you for your honesty.
You're welcome.
Look! We arrived at the pet cemetery.
Well, we love you, Misfortune, if it counts. I wonder why Morgo asks her that particular questions. To maybe weaken her by pressing her painful spots? Well, who knows, but whatever reason he does it, it's vibe.
Oh, check this out. More kids are missing. If I go missing, how will I tell mommy?
You won't go missing. We'll go back home right after we find the prize.
Okay, nice.
Yeah, sure. The kid looks like Hiro.
Ready to find the prize of eternal happiness.
Yes, what is it?
I have hidden it in one of the graves.
Oh, cool.
I have to dig in a grave? Which one?
I'll give you a hint. It's where the goldfish is buried.
The goldfish. All right. Must I dig with my tiny hands? Yikes forever.
No.
And out.
The shovel.
What shovel?
This shovel.
That shovel. Okay.
Yeah, I would really get creeped out if I saw that. I mean, where exactly did that shovel come from?
This one says, Denise died surrounded by her loved ones in a fire.
No, that doesn't clearly state it's a fish. Nah. So it's unlikely.
Okay. Let's see. Little Lulu, the first bug to ever strangle a man.
No, that's clearly a very violent dog.
No, I don't think this is the fish.
Or no, who knows what the man did too.
Stephanie Quinn, writer of the erotic novel Confessions of a Cat. Erotic novel? Talk about crazy!
Well, sure, hamsters have nude clubs, cats have erotic novels. That's how it works. That doesn't sound like a fish.
This is obviously a cat. It says, Paul died doing what he loved. It's simple.
Yay!
Yikes forever.
No, that doesn't sound like something a fish would do.
I don't think so.
Would it?
Let's see. Roger the Magpie. Never saw that window coming. I don't get it.
It's good that you don't get it. It's just a bird with a very ugly
death. I don't think so. I'll keep looking. It says, Mr. Bubbles.
Yeah, sounds like a very unoriginal fish name.
Congratulations, Misfortune. You found the prize.
Really? Yes.
You see the little box? Open it.
Oh, okay. Exciting.
Seems pretty little to fit eternal happiness.
Is this the prize? But there's only a note.
What?
Yes, it says, I stole your eternal happiness. Signed, Benjamin. It didn't! My eternal happiness!
I knew the fox was trouble. He stole your prize.
What a disappointment. I really wanted to surprise Mommy with this. What should I do now?
We must find the fox and get your happiness back. I'm sure he hasn't gone far away. Let's go find him.
Yes, let's do that. Oh, such a letdown.
Oh, but no, wait. We have to hear his version. And give happiness to the empty box!
Look, there he is! Benjamin, did you steal my eternal happiness? Not cool! Come on, Benjamin! Give me back my happiness!
Run after him! We can't let the fox get away again! He stole your prize!
Benjamin really disappointed me.
Yeah, but look, he left us another doll.
When unloved children in darkness search for what they have lost, for why they're in pain. Children in pain?
Did you find something, Misfortune?
Nah, you're imagining things.
Yep. Children in pain, like you. So yeah, for the ones who haven't played the game, apparently Benjamin sounds like a piece of trouble.
We should keep our eyes open in case we see the fox.
But there's more to it.
They know how to hide.
Let's take a look at this unusual rock.
Oh, shake out this stone. It's different from regular stones, I'm telling you.
I think you're right.
Oh, this piece is loose. I'll take it for me. Maybe it works somewhere else.
But if we take it, the text disappears. So before we take it, let's read what it says.
The game of death is what feeds the shadows of the beyond. Huh, what does this mean?
That looks like nonsense to me, Miss Fortune.
Huh, really? Maybe there's some more nonsense around.
Yeah, let's keep it. In case there's more nonsense around. Nonsense, sorry. And then let's see what waits for us ahead in the forest. I really love that she looks exhausted when she runs.
Looks very much like where the fox would hide the prize.
You mean I should go down there?
Yes, don't worry. Nothing bad will happen. Nothing bad at all.
Okay, you sound very sure. I'll trust you.
Yeah, maybe that's not the wisest idea.
I wonder why Benjamin will steal my prize. Maybe he's not happy himself. But I need that happiness myself. And for Mommy. Hello? Anybody down there?
And yeah, good thing that nothing bad like falling inside a hole was gonna happen, right, Mr. Boyce?
was a pretty big fall. Hello? Mr. Voice, are you there?
And suddenly he's not answering us anymore. Who knows why? But yay, we found a needle in a haystack.
Oh, damn. I dropped it.
Too bad.
Fox repellent? I can't deny the bottle sweet style. I'll take it.
Well, sure, the bottle's cute. It's a shame what it contains. But now maybe this lever will help us get inside whatever is behind those wooden bars.
Oh, there you are! What are you doing, Benjamin?
And no, no, she wouldn't want to do that. But yeah, okay, I don't use repellent on you and you pay me back by pushing us? Yeah, Benjamin, you're not helping your cause too much here. So it's taking a while longer to load, but I think this is coming.
What have I gotten myself into? She's such a mess. Maybe it was a mistake choosing her for this. I mean, I saw her eating glitter. Who does that?
Well, then leave her alone.
It's not natural. Misfortune, you're alive and well. That's great.
Yeah. Where am I? What happened?
The dangerous fox attacked you.
Benjamin attacked me? So he really is a bad fox.
See? I told you. That fox is evil.
Yeah, maybe I should listen to you.
We still need to find the fox and take back the eternal happiness.
Maybe we could find out where he lives.
Yes. Give me a minute to figure this out and I'll get back to you.
Okay, I'll just hang around.
All right. Let's wait for the autosave. And take a look around. So a local artist retires after his son goes missing, and the population of blackbirds has grown so big, it even is in the newspapers. Well, and the year is 1993, so technically this game is happening when I was 1 year old.
You know, with the animals?
I actually made a quick Google search. I found out the fox has a cousin in the zoo.
Oh, really?
We could go and see if he knows where the fox lives.
But how do we get to the zoo? It's like really far away.
Why, we take the bus, of course. There should be a bus stop nearby.
Okay.
Sure thing. And yeah, it's unbelievable how it's running later and none of her parents are looking for her in the street.
To the town center.
I carried you here.
But how? You're just a voice in my head.
Just a voice? No, I can do more than that, you know.
Prove it.
I don't need to prove anything to you.
Whatever you say, Mr. Voice.
Fine. You really want to see what I can do?
Wait, my shoelace.
She's gonna miss it. Poor light post.
There. Did you see? I'm not just a voice in your head, Miss Fortune.
What?
Did you see?
I'm sorry. I had a shoelace problem.
Let's just keep going then.
Yeah, it's good that you didn't see his show.
Hi, you look familiar. What?
Looked, you mean?
Then, wait a minute. Is that Daniela Bambini?
You know this child?
Yes, from school. She told our teacher to shove the homework up his butt. She's very Italian, you know.
She probably ran away from home. She will turn up soon.
You think so?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, I really don't.
Those people in the picture look so happy drinking their juice.
Sure, juice. Fermented juice.
Mommy brings me here all the time. It's really boring. Sometimes she sends me to buy cigarettes while she hugs strangers by the dumpster.
Is that so?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, do whatever you want, but why do you send your daughter? Or take your daughter?
Just dropped his wallet. What do you want to do?
And let's return it.
Wait, sir. You dropped your wallet.
You're welcome.
Is that for me? A lottery ticket? Cool. Thank you.
Well, have a look. Is it a winner?
Let's take a look. And no, it was going well.
No win.
Maybe next time.
One time mommy took me here and forgot me. I got to play inside all night until a security man found me. He thought I was a raccoon.
Well, that sounds like it was a fun night for you.
Yeah, except for me crying a lot, but it was fun.
Damn it. I mean, seriously, how can you forget her in there? Oh, wait, Sparkle Spot. Oh. Yeah, better imagine yourself as a raccoon.
It says, let's face it, sometimes we're just too tired to smile. Use happy face and stop pretending. Okay.
Yeah, that's why all adults in this game are wearing those. Apparently,
even
this man's child is
missing. Children posters. So many. I wonder what they're missing.
Oh, don't you worry about them. I'm sure they will all turn up one day.
You think so?
Of course.
I don't know, Mr. Voice. This is starting to smell mysterious.
Totally. Especially given the amount. And yeah, Mr. Boyce takes her for a fool, but I really don't think she is. I mean, she's a kid, she's naive, obviously, but she's no fool.
Here we are. Have you ever taken the bus all by yourself before?
No, I haven't. I'm not sure what to do. Do I need a ticket?
Let's find out. There's an information board.
Ah, look, we have to wait 2 minutes. Yikes forever. I can't wait to meet Benjamin's cousin at the zoo. I'm gonna tell how badly Benjamin behaved, and that Benjamin should be ashamed.
That sounds great.
But that will have to happen in 2 minutes.
It says that all children under 15 years old can ride the bus for free. I'm 8, so I'm good.
Great.
Yay!
Now that I think about it, maybe you'll need a bus ticket. You sound old.
I'm definitely older, but nobody can see me.
Okay.
I wonder how old is he?
Yes, more or less.
No, I mean, the boy sounds like a 40 or 50 year old man, but I wonder how old Morgo actually is.
Check this out. That street is called Dickens Road. Got it? Dickens Road. Dick.
Misfortune.
Yeah, I seriously don't get his problem with bad words. And that was not even one.
Hi, hello? Why did you take me to the sky with your friends? So you know, because of you, I can make to the party.
Well, to be fair, maybe that was for the best. Otherwise, he would have seen him hanging himself.
Should I sit down and wait?
Do as you please.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, sure.
I'll sit. I'm a bit tired from all the walking, you know.
I can imagine. You have very small feet.
Yes, I'm a little lady. That's what I am.
Yep. That's what you are, a
Check
little lady.
Those ladies out. They're a little scary, don't you think?
Honestly, I've seen worse.
Really?
Yes.
You know, my mommy also uses the same mask. She likes to hide her smile and tears behind it.
Would you like to have a mask like that?
Maybe. I don't know. The bus is here.
And that's weird. I can understand why you would like to hide your tears, but your smile too? And I don't like her mom, but that sounds like it really sucks feeling
this
like that.
This bus trip might take a while. Are you okay with that?
It's okay. Hiro is keeping me company.
Who is Hiro?
He's my friend from Japan. He's a ghost, you know. He's always saying,
You're really funny, Miss Fortune. There is no such thing as ghosts. Hey, Miss Fortune, look. There's a bunch of cows on the field.
Oh, I love cows.
Yeah, me too. I really do love cows. So let's take a look at what the little cows are doing. They're so cute.
That's so cute.
Well, okay, no, that wasn't cute at all. I mean, he was approaching so tenderly, and what the cow thought of doing was blow poo towards him.
Unlucky things seem to happen all the time.
Next time you're parking.
I think we're getting close to the zoo now.
Okay, great.
And yeah, I think we are. So let's let her get down off the bus.
Wow, here we are. I can't wait to go inside.
You have the ticket, right?
What ticket?
Oh, didn't I give you a ticket earlier?
What? No, you didn't.
Oh dear, I'm sorry. Totally forgot. Do you have any ideas on how to get inside, you know, without pain?
I saw mommy showing her boobies to the guy in the store and she got some free food. But I haven't got any titties yet, so that might not work.
I see. Well, I have an idea. What if we use diversion?
What does diversion mean?
Well, make the cashier look somewhere else, you know. Fool him.
Okay, let me think what I can do.
Yeah, because the boobs idea doesn't sound like something very nice to do, even if you have them. But we are gonna leave it until then, until here for today, so that we continue with the next part of Little Miss Fortune in English, Getting Inside the Zoo, in part 3. So let's save it on our third save. Yep, I wanna overwrite. And Mrs. Midnight hopes you had a nice time and hopes to see you next time. See you later, guys!